but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name, cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, cheers to the wish you were here but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back, memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. And you know I never try, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, oh. Cheers to the wish you were here but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Memories, yeah. And the memories bring back, memories bring back your.
There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back, memories bring back your. You know I'll never drop, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything will be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, oh. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. And the memories bring back, memories bring back your. Memories bring back, memories bring back your. Memories bring back, memories bring back your.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. And you are joining us from your homes, whilst just a few of us are present here at our college hall for this, the 2020 Form 5 graduation ceremony. So wherever you are, we kindly ask you, if you can, to please stand for the National Anthem of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago that will be performed this evening by James Smith, formerly of Form 5 Group 5, from his home, followed by the opening prayer by Master Christopher Sims, also from the comfort of his home.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gracious and loving God, we ask now for your almighty hand to be upon our graduates, teachers, school, and in thanksgiving for our parents and what they have done and continue to do as we celebrate this grand occasion virtually. Empower them to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love, guided by your light, so that they may use their talents to serve you, Lord Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. So please be seated. So to bid us welcome in this, our first ever virtual graduation ceremony, please welcome to the podium our principal, Father Gregory Augustine.
Members of staff, the Dean of Form 5, Mr. DeGill and Mrs. DeGill, parents and family members at home, students of the class of 2020, good evening and welcome to the Form 5 graduation ceremony at long last. My dear Fatima boys, gentlemen, this graduation begins your movement into adult life. It signals a new beginning, new hopes, new dreams, new aspirations await your creative energies. The college is proud to have been an integral part of that program of preparation for this new beginning. Yet, in many ways, this graduation is the continuum that is life. Life as a whole is like a series of concentric circles, with each turn carving a new path in ways both familiar and unfamiliar. Once again, Fatima College is honored to be one of those concentric turns that have prepared you to navigate with confidence and courage this imminent new beginning. Isn't this what life is about? The turning and turning of the wheels of time towards a destiny which, in faith, hope, and love, will bring you the happiness, peace, and godlike fullness we all desire. I will leave you with a reflection by a great monk and mystic, Saint Gregory of Nyssa, which I think encapsulates this thought. He says, "He who climbs never stops going from beginning to beginning, through beginnings that have no end. He never stops. May God bless your journey. I thank you." So now I introduce the Dean of Form 5, Mr. DeGill.
Principal, Father Gregory Augustine, Vice Principal, Mrs. Jillian Ramdas and Mr. Ramdas, teachers, parents, well-wishers, and boys of the graduating class of 2020, good afternoon. What a time for you to graduate. The most obvious backdrop of this moment is the ongoing global pandemic. Not to minimize the significance of its impact on every aspect of human living. I wish, however, to situate this moment beyond COVID-19. We also celebrate your graduation amidst the ongoing chants of Black Lives Matter, which has made its way from street demonstrations into politics, the arts, and even sporting arenas. This, along with other calls for equality and equity among people across a wide social and economic divide. You graduate at a time where there is an obvious tension between what you can do for your country against the dirge of what your country can do for you. In statements surrounding COVID-19, our own Prime Minister has focused the fight within two categories: lives and livelihood. There is concern for sustaining life with a global search for a vaccine and other treatments. Even our own University of the West Indies has become part of the fight through the engineering of new face shields and the engineering of new ventilator machines, which, instead of treating one patient at a time, has the ability of doing so for multiple patients. Growing concerns over our ability to feed ourselves as a nation has brought to the fore a greater conversation surrounding agriculture and food security. These conversations were accompanied by images of kitchen gardens from the precincts of the Prime Minister's residence and the Archbishop's house to the backyard of many ordinary citizens. In the last virtual term, I was surprised by the openness with which boys of my Form 1 religion class shared how their families have been affected by COVID-19. Some shared about the uncertainty of one or of both parents no longer having a secured income, or parents who were essential and frontline workers. A very stark reminder it was that no one, including the boy you sat next to for the last 5 years, is exempt from experiencing in some way the effects of this little microbe. The sphere of education was also victim to the demands of this pandemic, causing the format of your own CSEC exams to be altered and schooling carried out strictly in virtual spaces. Governments and educators are now ever more concerned with new equipment and connectivity to make needed adjustments for continued teaching and learning. Secondly, following acts of violence in North America, there has been growing activism across the world. Interestingly, this activism had different tones. It came with voices finding a rationale in support of and against particular actions and trains of thought. It was accompanied by peaceful demonstrations alongside hostile riots. In the only recently concluded CPL tournament, cricketers took the knee within their secure bubble. In the English Premiership and the NBA, uniforms were adorned with the words Black Lives Matter. But in this mixed bag of life, however, a national election would simultaneously precipitate sentiments which reveal and deepen racial and ethnic fault lines which exist in our society. I highlight these things tonight because these realities must give relevance to your academic, co-curricular, and social experiences here at Fatima. In reflecting on this, the graduating class of 2020, within these contexts, The words of our President Excellency Paulomy Weeks echoed in my mind. She asked the members of our 12th Parliament, can we trust you? Can we trust you to ask not what your country can do for you, but rather what can you do for your country? Can we trust you to contribute to future medical and engineering innovation? Can we trust you to become key players in giving life to a new and thriving green and digital economy? Can we trust you to become politicians, leaders, businessmen, priests, teachers, and fathers who will not be comfortable in a society filled with biases of every kind, which seek to reduce the dignity of the human person? In seeking to answer these, I pondered on the quality of people that I have observed over the last 5 years. I was pleased to recall the energy with which many of you became fully engaged in raising awareness on matters surrounding mental illness. Beginning as your Young Leaders Project in Form 4, the school looked on as green ribbons were sold, appearances on television and radio were made, and social media was taken by storm by a band of positive young men with the audacity of dreaming of a change, to change the negative stigma attached to those afflicted with some kind of mental illness. Under the supervision of our Dean of Form 1, Mr. Dale Brooks, and the leadership of your group president, Adam Bartholomew, persons such as 5-star General Master Tyler Contal-Borneo became noted for his drive in pushing the team forward. And Master Jonathan Manzano, emerging as the ever-passionate and articulate communicator. Notably, after the official conclusion of this project, your efforts did not end, but continued with even more ribbons and a greater and even push up challenges on social media, promoting awareness surrounding mental health issues. I am able to recount Professor Sims on the corridor outside my office on a particular afternoon, giving soft lectures to a selected friend before afternoon classes, and Mr. Shaw being very concerned with principles of business studies. It was as a result of the promptings of students such as Nathaniel Maxwell and Nicholas Leiber that is the reason now for our college having a new technology club. On the occasion of one of your classmates losing a parent, the outpouring of support was not forced. It came as a natural response. Even in times when, instead of my office being a place to heat your lunch, and rather becoming a place of reprimand, proved to be times of growth and learning. As in that instance, after one of you obtained your driver's permit and had a celebratory drive around the block, my stern reminder to you that you cannot answer for anyone's child was taken most graciously. As I speak here, I recount, and I saw it just as I left my office before coming to the hall, I recount Master Adam Sweet in my Form 1 religion class in Form 1 Group 4, after prolonged study of the Stations of the Cross, writing his own version of his own personal Stations of the Cross, where he would defeat me in the 5K. Mr. De Gale fell the first time. Mr. De Gale fell the second time, and so on. Well, Adam, I promise you that after this COVID-19 pandemic is over, we have a debt to settle. the young man chosen to speak on your behalf as class valedictorian, is today himself the personification of our motto. From Form 1 to present, he has been involved in swimming, triathlon, string ensemble, junior choir, senior choir. I'm sure if we did animal husbandry, he would have been there as well. And I dare to say at this moment, this young man, Adam Bartholomew, is a future recipient of an open scholarship and President's Medal. Again, memories return to me as I think of Adam. And that, interestingly, even though Adam stands out, it is not unusual for the Fatima boy to be so well-rounded, academically strong and socially vibrant. I think of Nicholas Gooding, Matthew Nualo, musical geniuses, scholars, students. This is not unusual for the Fatima boy. I mention these memories because what is needed by you, our future doctors, engineers, agriculturalists, and digital experts, is more than academic qualifications to meet the demands of our evolving world. It is more than people willing to protest for the removal of a statue that many did not even know existed. What is needed is a better quality of human being made visible in your everyday relations, made visible by those reflections that came to mind. These memories and others that we will carry of you give us a glimpse of this better man. We here at Fatima unapologetically have high expectations of you. And you must question the motives of those who only present to you an easier, more comfortable way of being. When those standards and expectations were not met, our chorus to you continues to be strive and conquer. Let it not be lost to you as well that you graduate during our college's 75th anniversary. As during any Jubilee celebration, we recount former times and people. Why call these to mind? Because you are part of a legacy. You are part of a tradition that has formed you beyond an external image. You stand on the shoulders of old boys and families who are great political and social exemplars for you. So now, I am able to confidently answer the question, can we trust you? In the affirmative, I do trust you to live Nintendo Vinches, to strive and to conquer. To your parents, who beyond today will continue in new ways to encourage, chide, and shepherd you, I offer a special word of thanks for the efforts in graduation fundraising and all the support given to preparing our boys, your sons, for their CSEC exams. I say thank you. Thank you to the parents who prepared graduation tokens, decorations, and the broadcast of today's proceedings. And I must make special mention here of the father of Nathaniel Maxwell, Mr. Lester Maxwell, who instead of being at home with his family to celebrate this moment, is here in the hall ensuring a smooth flow to this recording. I assure all of you that as an institution, we continue to learn and grow as we endeavor to provide an excellent learning environment for all our students. To my colleagues, your teachers, who are also logged on today, I extend special thanks for your commitment to your duties, even virtually, to continue your preparation for your CSEC exams. To Ms. Lindsay, Mrs. Farrier, Miss Roberts, Mr. Wolf, and Mr. Weath. You have been nothing short of stellar form teachers. Thank you for your dedication to your daily tasks. Finally, I return to you, the graduating class of 2020, and offer this prayer as you enter a new chapter of your lives. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. I thank you. So some of these boys who I was able to reflect upon gathered over the last couple weeks and worked very hard to put this next piece together. So wherever you are following this broadcast, please put your hands together for this musical item produced by boys of the graduating class of 2020.
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much to those boys. So Adam Bartholomew, Justin Chinchiang, Adam de Oliveira, Nicholas Gooding, Matthew Inkim, Xavier Jackson, Jonathan Joseph, Richard Maslin, Matthew Nualo, Matthias Noel, and James Smith. Let's hear it one more time for that excellent rendition. This student, I want to remind his mother, before, just at the time of his Form 1 registration and orientation, his mother said to me, "Mr. DeGale, you feel look good? Well, this one that come in, different." And well, he has proved his mother right. This student, in Form 1, participated in 2 inter-school swim meets competitively, in a triathlon. From Forms 1 to 3, in under 13 and under 14 levels, he was a goalkeeper. He was part of GoBag 7 Reflections. He served in the senior choir from GoBag 8 to 11, and then we would have 12 and 13. Music Festival Champions in 2018 and 2020, just before our lockdown. As I mentioned earlier, this young man was the group president for the Form 4 Young Leaders Project under the theme Mental Health Matters. This young man journeyed as a winner of the Make a Difference Award to We Day in Canada. He is part of the college band from Forms 3 to 5. He was part of the senior Pan Assam. He has been part of the Mystical Rose Prayer Group. He has been part of the String Assam. He has been part of the AV Club as a photographer. As I mentioned earlier, it is our expectation that this young man in the future will be the recipient of an open scholarship and President's Medal. Please welcome to the podium our valedictorian for the class of 2020, Master Adam Bartholomew.
Father Gregory, Mr. and Mrs. Ramdas, Mr. and Mrs. DeGale, teachers, parents, guardians, relatives, my friends, Good evening. I began to envision our graduation, arriving at the Hilton Hotel with our dates, walking down the long corridor to the ballroom dressed in suit and tie to meet our Fatima family, all of you. I never anticipated this pandemic and how it would change our lives. And while we cannot be together in person, through technology, we have gathered to celebrate these past 5 years at Fatima College. In 2015, we entered the school, having the awesome privilege of brand new smart boards and air conditioning in every single classroom, along with a newly built Form 6 block. And although we came from far and wide, we began to mesh as brothers in gray shirts and khaki pants. At our Form 1 orientation, we were nothing more than strangers, and it's beautiful to see how we've become what will be lifelong friends. In preparation for today, I gave my fellow graduates an online survey asking what Fatima has meant to them. The most popular answers were 1, family, 2, growth, and 3, home. When I think of Form 1, my mind takes me back to that party Mr. Cooper had organized for us on the last day of our Christmas exams. We gathered in the hall and exchanged secret Santa gifts before heading across to the court and field to sweat. That for me, after a hectic first term, was really the first time that I got to know the characters of our year group. And we've only grown exponentially closer since. For at Fatima, there's so much that binds us inextricably together, not only as a form, but with everyone else in the school. Indeed, we unify as brothers here, regardless of age or background, and we are certainly a family. One of the significant changes in coming into secondary school was a big increase in the number of teachers. Yet, in having so many teachers, with their various styles and idiosyncrasies, one thing remains constant, and that is their genuine love, care, and respect for us all. But they were not just concerned with how well we did in math, Spanish, POA, and biology, but were also aware and so supportive of whom we were as individuals and where our other interests lay. Music, for example, has been my passion and that of many others. The annual Gifts of Blue and Gold concert has fostered our love of music and courage in performance over the years. In music, like all the disciplines, we have been blessed to have student role models throughout the course of our journey here at Fatima. Perhaps most notably was Daniel Roberts, who we all remember as deputy head prefect when we were in Form 1. He seemed to live in his own musical bubble, yet, whether he knew it or not, he was a huge inspiration. He was just one of so many students in one of so many spheres who inspired us to do what we love, and I think it is our duty to inspire others through our love for what we do, as it is this inspiration which keeps passion alive. Indeed, there has been so much provided to us to ensure that we develop holistically. With God as the central focus of our school, we have been continually reminded of His Spirit in our presence. And we can't expect anything less, being students of this college, founded 75 years ago by the Holy Ghost Fathers, and led currently by Father Gregory, a spirit on himself, and moral compass to us all. Very rarely would you find a school principal who has gained the love and respect of every single student. We can all agree that Form 2 religion with Father Gregory was one of our favorite classes. This is when we really got to know our principal and his humor as he chopped our heads, took our pens and made us clean up the debris while the classroom filled with laughter. Yet, we will always remember the lessons he has taught us in faith, life, and leadership, and his warmth and humility will never be forgotten. He has helped us to understand that our spirituality extends beyond our prayers and into the way we live our lives as moral, kind-hearted individuals. Our identity is sculpted by the fact that God is our guide, enabling us to recognize that each of us has a unique purpose, and that only by being fearless and true to ourselves can we fulfill this purpose in life. Fatima has ensured that we grow into well-rounded young men. So, we are a family, we have grown, and it is these very things which make Fatima a home. Now, I think it's impossible for us to truly understand the role of our parents or guardians and appreciate all that they are and all that they do without being parents ourselves. It's obvious, we would be no one or nowhere without our parents. Needless to say that we would not have attended this college. And so, there really is no Fatima without our parents. And so on this, our graduation night, I want to say a special thank you on behalf of all of us to our parents and guardians. Yes, we have so much to be grateful for, yet we so often forget, and it takes us losing something to appreciate it. It's like on the 13th of March when it was announced that we would not be returning to school because of our first case of COVID-19 here in Trinidad and Tobago. Being locked down and taken out of school has allowed us to be far more grateful for it than ever before, as we can now understand how life is without it. In school, or anywhere really, we love to complain about petty things. But what this time has helped me to realize is that while an institution or system may not be perfect, there's so much beauty to see in it, and that imperfections are simply opportunities to improve. Likewise, as individuals, we need to embrace the fact that we are not perfect, and in so doing, we will allow ourselves to recognize our potential of becoming excellent. For instance, I know that our current under-20 football team is excellent. They were humbled through our relegation to the second division 2 years ago, but through striving last year, the new team has earned their place back in the first division, rediscovering their potential and what they must do to reach it. And so I have no doubt that next year, when football hopefully resumes, we will strive and conquer. For all of us, we have had this time to reflect and think about our lives. And I feel hopeful that we will find a renewed sense of purpose and fire within ourselves as we move forward despite these unprecedented times. We don't have to wait to lose something to be grateful. We don't have to be humiliated to be humble. And we don't have to be the best in order to inspire, for you don't know who you're inspiring while simply striving. While we can't be with each other in person, 2020 is engraved on our rings and Fatima on our hearts. So as Fatima class of 2020, may we never forget this year, these past 5 years, and each other. May we always be loving, grateful, humble, and continue to strive and conquer. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you very, very much, Adam, and I'm sure all of you at home can see very clearly how well-suited Adam was to be the valedictorian of the class of 2020. Let's hear it one more time. As I earlier mentioned, you stand on the shoulder of many old boys who have gone before you. So to bring a special message to you today, we have now the minister in the office of the Prime Minister, Mr. Simon de Nobrega.
Good evening, Father Gregory Augustine, teachers of Fatima College, parents, guardians, and of course, students and graduates of the Form 5 graduating class. I want to thank Father Augustine for giving me the opportunity to address you all this evening. And I want to say from the outset that this is going to be one of the proudest moments of my life. Proud because I am a proud Fatima boy. When you get to be my age, you get to be a proud Fatima, old boy. But secondly, and I think more importantly, Father Gregory would have asked me to give this address, but I asked him when he asked me if he was serious. And that is because while I was at school, I was most likely have been voted least likely to be the person on this end of the camera. You know, it's easy to think that the last 5 years of your life in Fatima have been about grades, getting good grades. But I think the two lessons that I want to impart to you, or at least the first two, are really about, firstly, that once you're a Fatima boy, you will always be a Fatima boy. And secondly, where you are today doesn't define who you will be later on in life. Some of you today are graduating Form 5 and will be leaving Fatima. Leaving Fatima to go on to other schools, or like me, entering the world of work. Some of you will have blossomed already. Some of you, like me, will blossom later on in life. The lesson to be learned here is, as I said, your life is to be defined as you go through it. But the fabric of Fatima College is woven into you. The culture of Fatima College is woven into you. Today, you stand as proud Fatima boys, and that is what you will be for the rest of your life. So, whatever career you eventually settle in, whatever path you take in life, know that you walk along that path, you enter that career as a proud Fatima boy, as a proud Fatima man. Who we are is not about the academic qualifications that we have. Yes, always strive to be the best. Yes, always strive for greatness. But being a Fatima boy is about the way we speak. It is about the way we think. It's about the way that we interact with others. These are the things that separate us from everyone else. These are the things that make us great. These are the things that make us Fatima. That culture of Fatima has been woven into you as it was woven into many generations before you and will be woven into the many generations to come. That culture of Fatima has created some of my best friends. I entered Fatima in 1986, and people that I sat next to in class, people that were my prefects in class, remain my best friends today. You know, we have fathers, we have farmers, we have psychologists. One of my friends in class became an academic scholarship winner to Yale. We have politicians, we have the top defense attorneys in Trinidad. But more than anything else, I have brothers. And as brothers, we are shoulder to shoulder and we march on. And as you march on, this is where you need to start paying forward by giving back. You have a responsibility. You have a responsibility to yourself. You have a responsibility to the school. You have a responsibility to your country. You have a responsibility to share the lessons that you have learned with the wider national public. So, give as much as you can. And this isn't about giving money. It's about giving time. join FOBA. FOBA is doing amazing work, not only for the school, but also for the wider national public. So get involved with the Fatima Old Boys Association, which is actually being led now by an old classmate of mine, Ludwig Thompson. But it doesn't stop there. Get involved in your communities. Get involved in positively changing the lives of others. If you can't do a lot, then do a little until you can do a lot. That is what we do. We are Fatima. You will learn, as I was forced to, that some of the hardest teachers, some of the toughest teachers over the last 5 years are going to be the sources of your greatest inspiration. That is true of life as well. And we are prepared for that as Fatima boys. You know, on your first day of school, you were taught that by striving, we shall conquer. And every day after that, you were taught to strive. So, from today going forward, with God as your guide, fearless and true, strive on, Fatima boys, strive on. Congratulations to you, the graduating class of Form 5 for 2020. Thank you.
Thank you very much to the Honourable Minister Simon de Norbrugge for your kind words as a Fatima old boy yourself. So we would like to have two things at this moment. So we'd like you to start preparing your glasses with wine for the toast. But before we have the toast, you at home, we did not have the opportunity, as would be our custom, to have the blessing of your school rings at our farewell mass. So wherever you are, we ask you to extend your hand, and Father will come to the podium and extend his blessing.
So the relatives, the parents, if they're grandparents and other siblings around you, and then place their hands upon you. There's no need to social distance at home. May the Lord bless these rings, which is a sign of your fidelity to your college. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
So to give you a few moments to prepare, that is why you, in your graduation package that you collected this morning, you would have received that magnificent bottle of wine. So we ask you to pop those bottles. It is a celebration. So please get your glasses of wine ready as we prepare to celebrate the graduating class of 2020 with a formal toast. And in the meantime, we have a wonderful slideshow that was prepared by the parents of this graduating year group.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever, and everything would stay the same.
Now my heart feel like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred. It was too powerful to stop. Oh, yeah. Now my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes. Everybody hurts someday. Yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your.
So let us now raise our glasses. And families, please, after we move this toast, we will show the homes. So be close so that the class of 2020. Cheers. So let's see those images, please. Of the families being close together. Ask you to everyone at home to please put on your videos, your cameras on your devices, because this moment is always a very moving moment for us. Live broadcasts always come. I think Father has enjoyed his toast thoroughly. If we were at the Hilton Ballroom at this moment, we honor the woman who brought you into this world, who carried you for 9 months without charge. So boys, wherever you are in your wearing your Sunday best and Monday special, Take, mommy, stand up. Put on your videos. We want to share in this moment. We already had to wait for so long to celebrate your graduation. And we now have the mother and son dance. So please take mommy. Mommy, let's take him. Hold him. Forever your son. For this mother and son dance. Enjoy this moment.
Not the big things, but the little things that can mean enough. A lot of prayers to get me through. And there is never a day that passes by I don't think of you. You are always there for me. Pushing me and guiding me. Always to succeed. You show me when I was young just how to grow. You show me everything that I should know. You show me just how to walk without your hands. 'Cause mom, you always were the perfect thing.
Always a very moving moment. And now I ask you to take out those cakes that you received as part of your graduation package. This is our common meal. Father is showing you the cake. father's favorite dietary group. So have your cake. We will continue our toast with this common meal as we share in these cakes. As we draw very near to the end of the formal part of this evening's proceedings. Cheers. So as we share in that, I ask now former Form 5 Group 1 student Evan Chatnat to move a vote of thanks. Evan, over to you.
Good evening, teachers, family members, and fellow graduates. It's my privilege to have been asked to provide today's vote of thanks for this evening's occasion. Today, I take the opportunity to put all my gratitude into words. On behalf of the families and students of Fatima College's outgoing class of 2020, I would like to firstly give glory to God for making today's occasion a resounding success. Although it was not what we had envisioned for graduation in times prior to now, the ceremony was still enjoyable. Next, I would like to sincerely thank Father Gregory and Mrs. Ramdas for their stewardship, vision, and commitment, as well as unstinted support from the beginning all the way through to the end. We appreciate you. Thank you. We are ever grateful to Mr. Stefan DeGale, whose words of wisdom and guidance have encouraged us. You provided us with the full nine yards when it came to being our dean. We are ever grateful for your kindness, interest, hospitality, and oversight that has been consistent from term one, day one. Thank you. A heartfelt thanks goes to the various heads of department and faculty whose unwavering dedication to us as students and willingness to go the extra mile ensure that we were ready for our CSEC examinations regardless of the ongoing pandemic. Thank you for making Fatima feel like less of a school and more of a family. We owe special thanks to parents in general who took an interest in our lives as students and men, as well as the members of the PSG who have been instrumental in communication between the school and its students. I would like to especially thank the parents who tested our temperature and made sure we went into the exam room sanitized, essentially putting themselves at risk to make sure that we were safe. Thank you. Finally, thank you, my fellow graduates, for without us, all this hard work and effort would be in vain. Thank you for always striving on, especially through the complications that resulted from the pandemic. It has always been up to us to reflect the ability of our teachers and parents, and it's inevitable that we would do just that and make them proud when we collect our results. I hope everyone has enjoyed their day, as well as this memorable occasion. And let us continue to stay safe as we weather the effects of COVID-19. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Evan. Thank you. And now we ask you, wherever you are, to please stand as we bring an end to the formal part of this evening's graduation. For the singing and the playing of the college anthem by Nicholas Gooding. Thank you. So we would ask Nicholas to just try that one more time to hopefully we may be able to get a better feed from where we are. In case you did not have that, we wish to share in our college anthem together. So Nicholas, one more time.
So you will continue the celebration at home. It is not ended. This is just the first part. So you continue your celebration at home until after midnight. Thank you. Good night.
Yeah.